Hello everyone and welcome back to Lewis News, your number one YouTube channel for all types of Spider-Man news. And in today's video, we are going to be talking about that Venom 3 plot leak that came out from 4chan a couple of days ago. Now, I must stress that this is a leak and a rumor, so obviously take it with a pinch of salt because this may not end up being true. However, with that being said, let's get straight into it. So I have a summary of the plot leaks on the screen right now, which I got from Reddit. And as you can see, I'm just going to read them out to you. It says that a recent 4chan leak contained the following in line with earlier leaks about the upcoming movie. Venom 3 is supposedly meant to be a standalone sequel to Madame Web, which is about the titular character and three Spider-Women protecting a pregnant Mary Parker and an unborn Peter Parker from the time traveler Ezekiel Sims. Madame Web will be set 10 years before Venom 1, which is why the earliest set leaks for the film have an early 2000s setting. Now, before we continue, let's just discuss that point. So this is saying that basically Venom 3 ties into the whole plot of Madame Web being a Terminator-style movie, being that movie where they protect Mary Parker, because obviously we know Ezekiel Sims comes from the future to kill Mary Parker, so Peter Parker is never born, thus Spider-Man is never created. And I really like the idea of that plot, I really like the idea of Madame Web, but once again, that is a rumored plot for Madame Web, that isn't actually confirmed. But this leak is actually referring to the Madame Web plot in the same sort of way, which means that potentially, like I say about all things, if more than one source is coming out and talking about something, the likelihood of it being true gets bumped up dramatically. But now that we've established that Venom 3 will have a connection to Madame Web, the leak also goes on to say, Venom learns through the aforementioned multiversal hive mind that Peter Parker slash Spider-Man is destined to kill them, references Raimi's Spider-Man 3. And this is where what earlier leaks were referring to when they said that Venom slash Eddie would explore the multiverse. They're simply looking through it via symbiote vision. And speaking on this point real quick, this is really interesting because like this leak mentions, we have had multiple rumors and multiple leaks come out stating that Venom 3 potentially will be tapping into the multiverse. We've also had leaks suggesting that Topher Grace's Venom will show up in this movie as well. And potentially this is the connection of how Topher Grace's Venom shows up from Spider-Man 3. We didn't know if it was just going to be a cameo. We didn't know if it was going to be a minor role, but we knew that in some capacity, he was going to be appearing in Venom 3. So it appears that if this leak is to be true, this is how Topher Grace's Venom, in fact, does show up in this film. As we know, Tobey Maguire's Spider-Man did kill the Venom symbiote at the end of Spider-Man 3, so that is the hive mind connection of how Venom knew Tom Holland's Spider-Man at the end of Venom 2 in that post-credit scene. Because once again, Venom knows Spider-Man through Tobey Maguire's Spider-Man through the hive mind of the other Venom symbiote that appeared in that movie, thus he knows Tom Holland's Spider-Man, or at least he recognizes him. Yeah, it's a bit complicated, but I think that's the way that they're going with it, or at least that's what all of these leaks are suggesting. Going on to the other points, it says Venom pursues Eddie to kidnap the 10-year-old Peter Parker of their universe. Obviously, Peter Parker will be 10 years old by the time of Venom 3, since Venom 1 took place 10 years after the events of Madame Web, in order to change their future, but Eddie refuses to harm him. So it seems like this is where the dramatic context for Venom 3 will come from. The decision of whether to kill Peter Parker as a 10-year-old boy or to take care of him and, you know, keep him alive. And I see this will be the decision that Eddie Brock and Venom have to come to. The next point goes on to say that Eddie slash Venom wind up forming a bond with 10-year-old Peter and must protect him when Detective Patrick Mulligan becomes toxin, goes insane, attributed to imperfect symbiosis, and sets out to destroy all monsters, including Venom, and for some reason, Peter. Now, this is where this kind of falls apart a little bit because it kind of just says, and for some reason, and even though if this plot leak does end up being true, and obviously it doesn't have all the information and all the little details here and there that potentially the full script might explain to us, I think it's a bit suspicious that it kind of just says, and for some reason, Peter, because Toxin is definitely going to be the villain of this film, or at least he's going to appear in Venom 3. I think that's fairly obvious since he was set up in Venom Let There Be Carnage. But when Toxin becomes the villain and sets out to destroy all monsters, it kind of just makes Peter Parker redundant in the plot. Like, it's almost like the film revolves around this younger Peter Parker, and it ties into Madame Web. But then the villain has nothing to do with Peter Parker. If you get what I mean, like, there's no tie. There's no reason for Toxin to want to go after Peter Parker. Toxin wants to go after Venom, which makes sense, but there's no reason for Peter to kind of be there. Peter's only there because they want to make a sequel to Madame Web, I guess. I don't know. But that's what this leak suggests anyway. And the final point says, at one point, Venom exposes young Peter to normal spiders, one of which bites him and causes an allergic reaction, which leads to Eddie having to take Peter to the hospital and to pretend to be his father. Which, I don't know, sounds really stupid. I don't really like that bit of this leak. Anyway, I can totally see this being the Venom 3 plot leak, just because of how ridiculous the plot is. Like, I'm not gonna lie, that is the plot. I'm here to report on it unbiasedly, but my honest opinion is I don't really like this. I think Venom 3 should just be a standalone thing. The Venom franchise has been a standalone franchise thus far. Just leave it alone. Just let Venom 3 happen before you start crossing stuff over and connecting things, because at this moment in time, Madame Web is going to be the movie that ties everything together. Madame Web is going to be the movie that kind of culminates everything in terms of spider people in live action for the Sony universe. Just leave Venom 3 alone, you know what I mean? You don't have to make it a standalone sequel to Madame Web, which, you know, would completely detract from Venom. You're basically just using Venom to make a sequel, and I think Venom deserves to have a sequel by himself. As much as the previous two movies weren't critically acclaimed, I do think three movies in, I think Tom Hardy deserves a movie that's just about his character. I don't think you need to involve Peter Parker at all. I think this plot is stupid, but either way, if it turns out to be true, hey ho, maybe it might be good. Maybe it'll be cool. I'm very excited for Madame Web though, so, you know. But let me know what you think in the comment section down below. What do you think about this plot leak? Do you like it? Do you not like it? Let me know in the comment section down below. Hopefully you all enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to hit a like on it and make sure to subscribe if you are new and hit the bell so you do not miss any more Spider-Man news. I post everything from the games and movies and the shows, all news regarding Spider-Man. This is your channel for Spider-Man news. With that being said, thank you guys for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Take care and peace.